This program is rated PG. It contains themes and scenes which may not be suitable for very young audiences. Parental guidance is advised.
Be advised that the views and opinions of the hosts and guests do not reflect those of the station.
Magandang araw po sa inyo lahat. Ito ang ating pangkalagitnaan ng Abril na paglalabas ng ating Talk News TV at ating pag-usapan itong mga importanteng mga issue itong nakaraang mga araw. Una-una, kami nagbibigay tribute kay the late attorney Oliver Lozano. And we entitled this segment as a tribute to him initially because we will have another one later on with maybe one or two of the children joining us to pay tribute again. And I say that Attorney Oliver Lozano is a man of conviction dahil ito ay nakilala ko sa aking apat na pung taon, ano, at least 40 years. Probably more, probably 50 years. Dahil nag-aktivista ako when I was 18. Ano? I'm now 67. And I began with a very low regard because I was of Attorney Lozano because he was a so-called Marcos Loyalist and I was with the, shall we say, the elite political groups associated with Edsa Uno and so on. But over time, I gained more and more respect for Attorney Oliver Lozano for his firm conviction, staying with the deposed president, President Marcos, and always a critic of the succeeding governments and the policies of the succeeding governments. He participated in the political actions such as the attempted swearing-in of Vice President Arturo Tolentino in 1986, right after Edsa Uno, where Tolentino and company and the Marcos so-called loyalists believed that the election victory was with Marcos and with Arturo Tolentino, and Marcos was already sent off to Pauai in Hawaii, and Arturo Tolentino, including Attorney Lozano and the remaining supporters of Marcos tried to assert their constitutional mandate, you know, at the time. Oliver Lozano was born on May 13, 1940 in Ilocos Norte. It was still the Philippine Commonwealth at that time. He graduated law from the University of the Philippines, was a key member of the Kilusang Bagong Lipunan, the movement and party of President Marcos. And we invited somebody who has known Attorney Lozano even when he was a kid, and his father was an associate in many of the activities of Attorney Oliver Lozano. And this is, of course, our regular guest and resource person, Mr. Ferdy Pasion of Nationalist Filipino. Tell us a bit more about what you know of Attorney Lozano.
Well, as far as I can remember, when I was still a kid, my father and Attorney Oliver Lozano were not really fanatics of President Marcos because they were then fanatics of the Filipino people, of the consumers, the laborers. That's why They were together in the Consumers Union of the Philippines, fighting for the rights and welfare of the consumers, and with the labor movement, because my father was a labor leader back then. Ano? So during the time of President Marcos, there were many times that they were at odds with the administration. And but in fairness to President Marcos, every time he sees that what my father and attorney Oliver Lozano are fighting for are reasonable, he takes the side of the consumers and the laborers. And what happened then after Edsa Uno was not my father and attorney Lozano being rabid pro-Marcos. No, far from it. They were just for the rule of law and the defense of the Constitution. Because the Batasang Pambansa back then declared that the winner is Marcos and Tolentino. So going by the Constitution, it is Vice President Arturo Tolentino who should succeed the legitimate president, because the president was kidnapped. Instead of being taken to Pawai, he was taken to Hawaii by the Americans against his will. So it should be the Vice President Arturo Tolentino who should take over. That's why the Manila Hotel so-called siege happened.
Yeah,
after that, the GMA siege by Colonel Oscar Canlas.
Good, you clarified the Pawai is in Ilocos. Not in Hawaii, which I made a mistake of. It is in Makiki Heights in Hawaii. That Marcos stayed for the rest of his life.
That's why there's the book
away.
From Malacanang to Makiki.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and just to add to the information Ferdy has just mentioned, attesting to his social activism and conscience, Attorney Oliver Lozano was legal counsel for the Philippine Consumers Foundation, the Unification Movement, World Unification Church, Apostolic Catholic Church, Jesus is Lord Crusaders. This is the lesser known aspect of Attorney Oliver Lozano.
He's a Bible reader.
Mm-hmm. The Lord Jesus Christ, the Great Commission World Ministry, and then the Active Civilian Force Incorporated. The item you see on the screen now is his most recent, or maybe the last Facebook post that I could find, where he has been again telling what he feels is the truth about the past decades from the time of Marcos to the present. And he was saying that Ferdinand Marcos was veering away from U.S. imperialism, and he brought down the Iron Curtain, established diplomatic relations with Russia. He brought down the Bamboo Curtain and established diplomatic relations with China, and other achievements of Marcos. And in the later part, Attorney Lozano was reiterating the sins and deceptions of Tuwid na Daan, of Cory Aquino, and so on. So he had been consistent in all these for 40 years, when many of his fellow travelers on the Marcos camp had moved on to become yellow in color. You know? So that is why we say he has been a man of conviction. And in my case, from my disdain to my respect for him over those 40 years, because I saw here a man consistent with his conviction, his sacrifice for what he believed is the truth, his activism, his political involvement to pursue those ideals. Let's go back to Ferdy. What else would you like to add?
Well, to show his conviction, Attorney Oliver Lozano, together with other leaders of the so-called Marcos Loyalists, Colonel Cabawatan and my father, they undertook the Batak to Manila march, where they physically marched all the way from Batak.
How many days did that take? Do you recall?
Several weeks. They had to have many stopovers.
Yeah, of course.
There was a skirmish.
What year was that?
86,
87?
Yeah, somewhere during those times. There was a skirmish in Tarlac, of course.
Uh-huh,
they were not allowed to pass through. So But later on, they were able to pass through Tarlac with the help of Henry Coanco, brother of Danding. And then, of course, in Pampanga, they were assisted by the supporters of Estelito Mendoza.
Mm.
So they were able to arrive in Manila. And we went to the house of, I remember, of Speaker Iñiguez. Upon arrival.
Did you join the march all the way or
no,
the only
from,
part of the way?
From north northern part of Manila, I just waited there.
You were only a teenager at the time?
Yes, I was still very young then. Mm. And of course, during my time together, I shared the beliefs of Attorney Lozano. During my time, I was also not a rabid supporter of Marcos. I was an activist. But there are some things that we have to defend, like the basic principles of rule of law, constitutionalism, and industrialization. By the way, Attorney Lozano firmly believed in the Filipino ideology that instead of exporting our natural resources, we have to convert them into finished goods. So that we will achieve economic independence. That's why he is very well-grounded, no? A holistic person, spiritual, economic, etc. So he's not just purely on the legal side.
Yes. Well, to continue to add to the voluntarism of the record of voluntarism of Attorney Lozano, he was also legal counsel for the Economic Recovery Action Program Incorporated, Motherland International Foundation Incorporated, National Organization of Women Agenda, Poverty Incorporated, Muslim League of Welfare Development Incorporated, Trade Union of the Philippines, Action Bayan Inc., and Quezon City Federation of Women Civic Organizations. And he ran for the Senate under the KBL in 2004 and 2007. Mm. So this is the record of the man who, despite all the pressures and the challenges, stuck to his guns, so to speak, and saw the revival and the resurgence of the Marcos, shall we say, movement based on what Marcos had done before, his ideology, a revolution from the center, Filipino ideology, and so on. So how would you wrap up his life? He's from Batac, from Dingras, Ilocos Norte, of course. And what insight can we pick up from Attorney Lozano?
Well, first of all, we have to love God and our country above ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
And the Filipino people, even above our own family.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes we have to sacrifice even our own family, our time with our own family, our finances, for the greater good. So that's what I have learned from Attorney Oliver Lozano. It's not all about money.
Yeah. Well, we visited the wake of Attorney Lozano together yesterday, and I discussed with the daughter and the friends there, and we certainly will miss Attorney Lozano in the front pages of our newspapers in the coming years. But his memory will be there, and what he stood for, his courage and his strength of conviction, I personally will remember, and I give him tribute for that. So with that, we'll move on to our second subject matter, which is the Boao Forum, where President Duterte recorded a lot of achievements again with President Xi Jinping. Okay, let's take this break.